Good afternoon, everyone. So today we are going to learn about Mycobacterium tuberculosis, Mycobacterium leprae, atypical mycobacterium. Practical of Mycobacterium tuberculosis, Mycobacterium leprae, atypical mycobacterium. Competencies. Which the topic is taught that student should able to perform and identify the causative agent of infectious disease by ZN staining, and competencies required, skill, performance, score is required. Assessment will be skill based. Second competency, 6.1, which describes the etiopathogenesis, laboratory diagnosis, prevention of infections of upper and lower respiratory tract. There you should know about the etiopathogenesis, laboratory diagnosis of upper and lower respiratory tract. You should know how they cause the particular infections of upper and lower respiratory tract. Should be a lecture or small group discussion, and the assessment will be based on written examination, also in the live hours. Next competency, 6.2, where it identifies that student must be able to identify the common etiological agents of upper respiratory tract infection by biopsy and ZN stain. This is also skill based. Performance based assessment. 6.3, identify common etiological agents of lower respiratory tract. Should be able to identify them by demonstrating through Yamsin ZN stain. And assessment is skill based as well as lecture based. Where you should know are the etiological agent of the cause of respiratory tract infection. This also can be assessed through IVA as well as written examination. Next competency is 8.16, which describes the student should know the national health programs in prevention of common infectious disease. This is general for the general information purpose. Next slide is of aims and objective. At the end of this session, students should be able to understand the classification of mycobacterium, antigenic structure, pathogenesis, clinical manifestations, laboratory diagnosis, treatment, drug resistance, and prophylaxis of mycobacterium tuberculosis infections. Students must know newer anti-tubercular drugs and the global and national tuberculosis prevention programs. Students should understand about classification, lab diagnosis, and treatment of multivalent mycobacterium, classification, antigenic structure, pathogenesis, clinical manifestation of laboratory diagnosis, treatment of mycobacterium leprae responsible for causing Hansen's disease. So we start with the introduction. Mycobacterium tuberculosis as an organism responsible for causing pulmonary tuberculosis. Okay. So here you must know about the morphology of this organism, as we are talking about the practical session. The mycobacteria, they have several species which produces various kinds of infections. They can be ranging from pulmonary to extrapulmonary tuberculosis, as well as cutaneous infection. And the common properties of mycobacterium are as below. That first comes is the acid fastness, which is the unique property of these group of organisms, and that can be express or explain as that they resist depolarization by dilute mineral acids. This acid fastness is due to the presence of high content of mycolic acid in the cell wall of these mycobacteria group of organisms. The integrity of the cell wall of this particular group of organisms. And this property is used as an important identification marker in the diagnostic laboratories. These organisms, they are non-flagella, they are non-motile, cannot form spores, so they are non-sporic, they don't have a capsule, but they are non-capsulated. If they stain by capsule, they are weakly gram positive. Whenever they are observed through microscope, they appear straight or slightly curved off shield bacteria, and these are obligate aerobes. Sometimes, if they do show branching filamentous form, resembling fungal mycelia, and hence the mycelia will spout us, reflecting the mold like pellicle formation on liquid media, and therefore the name is mycobacteria. History: on 24th March 1882, tuberculosis bacilli was isolated and proved as its causative role in causing tuberculosis. 24th March 1882, Robert Koch announced the discovery of this causative agent of tuberculosis, Mycobacterium tuberculosis, to the World Physiological Society and proved its causative role. He became as a father of bacteriology. He received the Nobel Prize in Physiology in 1905. Next slide is of classification. Mycobacterium tuberculosis, mycobacteria are classified into Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex, that's responsible for causing tuberculosis in humans. Mycobacterium debris, responsible for causing Ensign's disease, or also known as Ensign's bacilli, causes leprosy, characterized by anesthetic skin patches and lesions of the peripheral nerves. If not treated, can lead to deformities affecting eyes, nose, hands, and feet. Non-tuberculous mycobacteria, or also known as NTM, these are diverse group of mycobacteria. They are either saprophytic in nature, for example, Mycobacterium gordoni from the tap water, or may be found as common cell, for example, Mycobacterium smigmatis in urine. Some can cause opportunistic human infections, for example, Mycobacterium cancer. Tuberculosis. Tuberculosis caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex is one of the oldest diseases of humans and a major cause of death worldwide. It usually affects lungs, and the other organs are also involved. Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex includes Mycobacterium tuberculosis, the most common species to cause human tuberculosis, bovis, bovine tuberculosis bacillus, and other members. They are less common in human, less common causing human infections, such as Mycobacterium africanum, Mycobacterium microti, Mycobacterium tapiri, Mycobacterium pinniferi, Mycobacterium canti, Mycobacterium suricati, Mycobacterium bulgis, Mycobacterium mundi, and the recently described disease bacillus and chimpanzee bacillus. However, they can be distinguished from each other by certain properties, such as antigenic structures of Mycobacterium. Here we are talking about antigenic structure of Mycobacterium tuberculosis. There may be of two types: cell wall or in-cell antigens, which includes peptidoglycan layer, maintains the shape and rigidity; arabinogalactan layer, which helps in survival of tuberculosis within macrophages; mycolic acid layer, the principal constituent, gives low permeability for the antibiotics, acid fastness, hence reduces the entry of most antibiotics; outermost layer, liquid, glycolipids and phytosides. Cell wall antigens or insoluble antigens also enhance proteins, for example, purine transport proteins found throughout the various layers. Plasma membrane that helps in attaching the host cell, and also it's a target antigen used for the diagnosis of infections. Cytoplasmic antigens, those are soluble antigens that includes antigen 5, antigen 6, antigen 60, and are used in serodiagnosis of tuberculosis. The structures explains the cell wall of mycobacterial tuberculosis. You can see here the mycocytes, layers of mycolic acids, arabinogalactan, peptidoglycan, lipoarabinomalan, cell wall membrane. This can explain better. Protein structure. Pathogenesis. First slide, source of infection. The source of infection of Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex may be human, for example, a case of pulmonary tuberculosis. Next source can be bovine source, for example, after consumption of unpasteurized infected milk. Pathogenesis. Next slide is mode of transmission. Modes of transmission includes airborne, main route of infection, through inhalation of aerosols released after coughing, sneezing, or speaking by the infected individual. They can be in the tiny droplet, dry droplet nuclei, measuring about less than 5 micrometer in size. They are able to suspend it in the air for several hours and are easily inhaled. There may be as many as 3,000 infectious nuclei per cup. Other mode of transmission, which are rare, includes inoculation and ingestion. Inoculation, when there is a transmission of infection through direct skin contact or with an infected person, is very rare. Ingestion, swallowing of sputum in case of infants, or consumption of unpasteurized infected milk. Risk factors: sputum positive patients, sputum showing acid plus tubercle bacilli in microscopy are labeled as patients. Sputum showing acid plus bacilli in the microscopy are labeled as sputum positive patient. They can transmit more effectively than sputum negative patients. The bacillary load in these cases, at least 10 raised to 4 bacilli per ml in sputum, is required for an effective transmission. Adult patient with the cavitary lesions in the lung, a more bacillary load sputum, that is, can be 10 raised to 5 to 10 raised to 7 AP per ml, therefore transmit more efficiently. Overcrowding and poor ventilated load. Low cell-mediated immunity, for example, HIV-infected individuals, other comorbid conditions such as post-cirrhosis, post-transplantation, renal or cardiac, jejunal bypass, gastrectomy, chronic renal failure, hemodialysis, diabetes, IV drug abusers, smoking, etc., includes other comorbid conditions which are the risk factor of developing Mycobacterium tuberculosis infection. Risk factor, according to the as per the male-female ratio, female with the age of 25 to 34 years are at higher risk, while older age men have greater risk. Sequence of pathogenesis. Droplet nuclei containing tubercle bacilli from an infectious patient are released after coughing, sneezing, or talking, are inhaled by the other individual. Then majority of these inhaled bacilli, they trapped in the upper airways. Most of them are expelled out by the ciliary action of mucosal cells. Only usually less than 10% small droplets they can reach to the alveoli. After reaching there, they can adhere to the macrophages. Here, mycobacterial surface lipoarabinomannan lamp binds to the complementary receptors and the mannose receptor present on the surface of macrophages. This gives access in internalization of this bacilli. Phagocytosis by macrophages, it enhanced by complement C3b mediated oxidization of bacilli. Survival inside the macrophages is explained. This is due to the bacterial cell wall of lamp, which impairs phagosome lysosome fusion by inhibiting an increase in intracellular Ca plus and phosphatidylinositol 3-phosphate. If the bacilli are successful in arresting phagolysosome fusion, they are happily replicate inside the macrophages. The macrophages eventually rupture and release its bacillary content, which infect the other infected phagocytes. An infection cycle continues. Host immune response, cell-mediated immune response. Host cell-mediated immune response to the tubercle bacilli is critical to contain the infection. Macrophages present these mycobacterial antigens to T helper cells, and these get activated. Then to Th1 and Th2 subsets, where Th1 cells release cytokines, and such cytokines such as interleukin-2, interferon gamma, which activate monocytes and macrophages. These activated Th1 cells leads to the development of two host responses. First, macrophage activating response, and the second, tissue damaging response. Macrophage activating response where interferon gamma activates the resting alveolar macrophages into activated macrophages, which are capable of killing and digesting tubercle bacilli. These activated macrophages aggregate around the center of the lesion and form characteristic granuloma, which is known as tubercle. Tubercles are the essential pathological findings in tuberculosis. Formation of tubercle is a favorable sign. They are primarily of two types, hard tubercle and soft tubercle. Hard tubercles are initially hard, composed of central zone having activated macrophages, which are known as epitheloid and giant cells, and the peripheral zone of lymphocytes and fibroblasts. Second tubercle is the soft tubercle, which form latter. Central part of the lesion undergoes gaseous necrosis and it contains necrotic material resembling soft cheese. Growth of mycobacterium tuberculosis is inhibited within this necrotic environment because of low oxygen tension and low pH. Eventually, lesions heal and calcify. The viable bacilli may remain dormant within macrophages or within the necrotic material for many years without causing further tissue destruction. Next, mechanism, tissue damaging response. In this minority of cases, this especially those with the risk of factors. As mentioned above, the macrophage activating response is weak and the bacilli are more virulent. Here, the mycobacterial growth can be inhibited only by intensified delayed hypersensitivity reaction, which leads to lung tissue destruction. spread of caseous necrosis becomes liquid here. The caseous necrosis becomes liquefied, containing large number of bacilli, which further spread by three ways: direct drainage into the airways, and then get discharged into the environment while coughing and talking. Second, lymphatic spread. Here, they reside into the same or opposite lung and then disseminated to other organs. Third, hematogenous spread, various organs, especially among young children with immature immunity. Hematogenous spread may lead to fatal meningitis, tuberculosis or tuberculous meningitis. Humoral immune response. The Th2 subset cells derived cytokines such as interleukin-4, interleukin-5 and activate B cells to produce antibodies. Mycobacterium tuberculosis, being an obligate intracellular parasite organism, humoral immunity plays a minor role. However, the anti-lipoarabinogen antibodies play a role in preventing dissemination of tuberculosis in children. Clinical manifestations of tuberculosis are classified as pulmonary and extraordinary forms. Pulmonary tuberculosis accounts for 60-90% of all cases of tuberculosis. It can be further categorized into primary or post-primary, that is secondary types. Extrapulmonary tuberculosis results from hematogenous dissemination of tubercle bacilli to various organs. Though these constitute about 10-40% of cases of all tuberculosis in HIV positive patients, the frequency is much higher, accounting up to 2/3 of all cases of tuberculosis. Virtually all organs systems may be affected, however, the sites are commonly involved. Now this is comparison of primary and secondary pulmonary tuberculosis. Features: primary tuberculosis results due to initial exogenous infection with tubercle bacilli. Post-primary adult type or secondary pulmonary tuberculosis due to exogenous reinfection or due to endogenous reactivation of latent primary lesions. Major age group affected in primary tuberculosis are children, and in post-primary usually adults. Parts of lung commonly affected: subpleural lesion affecting upper parts of lower lobe and the lower parts of upper lobe in primary tuberculosis, while in post-primary, apical and posterior segments of the upper lobes where the high oxygen tension is. The lesions formed at the initial sites in primary tuberculosis don't focus, that is a fibrotic nodular lesion which is formed. In case of post-primary, seamless focus, which is hematogenous seeding in the apex of the lungs, and SMN focus, that is reactivated seamless focus with central lesion. Lymph nodes in primary pulmonary tuberculosis don't focus with associated Hilal lymph node adenopathy is commonly called as primary complex, while in post-primary, lymph node involvement is unknown. Clinical features: primary tuberculosis may be asymptomatic or may present with fever, productive cough with or without hemoptysis, and occasionally chest pain, night sweating, weight loss. Post-primary pulmonary tuberculosis lesions are undergoing necrosis and the tissue destruction, leading to cavity formation. Symptoms are similar but more pronounced. Fate of primary pulmonary tuberculosis: lesion heals spontaneously, primary complex become calcified, known as Ranke complex. Post-primary tuberculosis or adult type of secondary pulmonary tuberculosis, bronchiogenic spread to the same or opposite lung that forms the satellite lesion leads to caseating pneumonia. Hematogenous spread to various parts of the body and granuloma formation, which is rare, heals spontaneously. Now here, the CT scan of lung showing cavitation in the left upper lobe suggestive of pulmonary tuberculosis. Extrapulmonary tuberculosis. Lymphadenitis, tuberculosis lymphadenitis. It is the most common form, mainly seen in children, accounting for 35% of all extrapulmonary tuberculosis cases. Most common sites are posterior cervical and supraclavicular lymph nodes, present as painless swelling in the neck region without warmth or color change. Pleural tuberculosis accounts for 20% of all cases of EPTB. It presents as pleural effusion. Tuberculous empyema is less common complication that develops due to rupture of cavity into pleural space with spillage of tubercular bacilli, which may form a bronchial pleural fissure. Tuberculosis of upper airways involving larynx, pharynx, and epiglottis or senses. Dyspnea and chronic productive cough are the common clinical presentations. Extrapulmonary tuberculosis, genitourinary tuberculosis, renal tuberculosis are the major complications. Genital tuberculosis in female patients, fallopian tubes, and the endometrium are commonly involved, causing infertility. In male, epididymis is the most common site. Skeletal tuberculosis. Weight-bearing joints such as spine, Pott's disease or tuberculosis, spondylitis is the commonest name for it. Hips and knees are commonly affected with the advanced disease. Collapse of vertebral bodies result in gibbous and a paravertebral collapses can also be seen. Tuberculosis of CNS, mostly seen children. Meningitis, tuberculosis meningitis or tuberculoma are the common forms. Gastrointestinal tuberculosis, terminal ileum and cecum are the most common site involved. The route of spread may be due to swallowing of sputum with direct cilium, hematogenous spread, or ingestion of cow's milk infected with Mycobacterium bovis in developing countries. Tuberculosis peritonitis occurs either by direct spread, rupture, lymph nodes, or hematogenous cilium. Extrapulmonary tuberculosis continue with genital tuberculosis, terminal ileum and cecum are the most common site involved. The route of spread may be due to swallowing of sputum with direct cilium, hematogenous spread, or ingestion of cow's milk infected with Mycobacterium bovis. This is usually seen in developing countries. Then, tuberculosis skin lesions that include scrofulous edema, scrofuloderma, that is where the skin involvement by direct extension from underlying tuberculosis lymphadenitis. It's a skin condition caused by tuberculosis involvement of the skin by direct extension, usually from underlying tuberculosis lymphadenitis. Lupus vulgaris, apple jelly nodules are formed over the face seen in females. Medially or disseminated tuberculosis. Hematogenous spread of tubercle bacilli results in the formation of yellowish 1 to 2 mm size granulomatous lesions resembling millet seeds, thus termed as medially. In various organs, it is more common in HIV infected individuals. Post TB aspergillosis, chronic pulmonary aspergillosis may develop due to colonization of aspergillus fumigatus in residual GB cavities. It may manifest as a simple aspergillum, fungal bot, or chronic cavitary aspergillosis. It presents as respiratory impairment, hemoptysis, and weight loss. HIV-associated tuberculosis is one of the most common opportunistic diseases among HIV-infected persons due to low cell-mediated immunity. Worldwide, tuberculosis occurs in 70-80% of HIV-infected individuals, EPTB being more common than PTB. Common presentation are lymphatic, disseminated, pleural, and meningitis. Epidemiology. Quarter of the current world population is infected asymptomatically with Mycobacter tuberculosis, of which 5-10% develop the clinical disease during their lifetime. World scenario, WHO has estimated 10 million new cases of tuberculosis occurred in 2018 with global incidence of 113 new cases per 1 lakh population per year. That's due to tuberculosis, about 12 lakh in HIV negative, 2.5 lakh in HIV co-infected people are reported in 2018 worldwide. WHO regions, Southeast Asia, the percentage is 44%, followed by Africa, 24%, and West Pacific region, 18%. Eight countries accounted for 2/3 of the total burden of tuberculosis, with India having the largest share. India has reported 27 lakh cases occurred, with the highest burden from Uttar Pradesh in 2018. WHO region, Southeast Asia 44%, followed by Africa 24%, and Western Pacific 18%. Laboratory diagnosis. Specimen collection in pulmonary tuberculosis. Two sputum samples are recommended, spot sample collected on the same day under supervision and the early morning sample collected on next day. Alternative two spot samples at least 1 hour apart can be collected. Sputum collection booths should be located away from other people outside in an open, well-ventilated space as the air dilute the aerosols generated during coughs. Early morning sputum specimen should be collected in empty stomach after rinsing mouth well so as to remove any food remnants as they are interfere with the smear examination. Inhale deep. Patient should be instructed and advised to inhale deeply 2-3 times and cough out from the chest during exhalation and then to spit the sputum into wide mouth screw capped container. It should be sterile. Sputum should be at least 2-5 ml in quantity. Thick and fluorescent yellowish mucus should be visible. Salivary specimen with water should be rejected. Extrapulmonary tuberculosis specimens vary depending upon the site involved, which can be divided into two categories. Sterile site specimen collected aseptically. Optical specimen CSF, pericardial fluid, synovial fluid, ascitic fluid. Suboptimal specimen where organism load is less, such as pleural fluid, 20-50 ml is collected and centrifuged. Blood, as per indicated, only for disseminated tuberculosis and co-infected with HIV. Specimen type 2 specimens containing normal flora, swabs, urine, stool. Swabs considered suboptimal specimen, the only recommended swabs are laryngeal and swabs from discharging sinuses. Laryngeal swab should be collected early morning, empty stomach. Urine, three early morning specimens should be collected, 500 ml per specimen should be centrifuged. And this should be collected on different days as TV, as a line, urine, or shaded internet. Stool for disseminated tuberculosis in HIV-infected individuals and infants. Digestion, decontamination, and concentration. Sputum and specimens from non-sterile sites subjected to smear microscopy and culture as per the need. Right. The treatment for digestion to liquefy the thick pus cells and homogenization. Decontamination to inhibit the normal flora and concentration to increase the heat. However, the steps into required. However, this steps is not required for molecular methods and also for processing of extrapulmonary specimen collected aseptically from sterile sites. Commonly used methods are modified Petrox method, 4% NaOH, where the sputum is mixed with 4% sodium hydroxide, centrifuged, and the sediment is neutralized with phosphate buffer saline. This method is recommended for algae culture. Second method is NALC, N-acetyl-L-cysteine, with 2% of NaOH. This is superior to Petrox method for acetylation. NALC liquefies sputum and NaOH kills the normal flora. This method is more compatible with automated culture systems. Other specimens for extrapulmonary tuberculosis includes other respiratory specimen, bronchial secretions, can be collected to 5 ml bronchial under the vase, 20 to 50 ml transbronchial and other biopsies collected in sterile normal saliva. Gastric lovers recommended for children tend to swallow sputum or ICU patient on aspiration. Early morning lavage should be collected and processed early within less than 4 hours. Direct microscopy by acid for staining or Zeal Nelson staining, hot method. The smears are prepared from thick mucopulum part of the sputum or with the sediment obtained after concentration. Optimum thickness of the smear can be assessed by placing the smear on printed matter. The print should be just readable through the smear. Then the smear is stained by acid for staining method. Acid for staining method, which is described as first you have to take this smear, air dry it, and then place for microscope. Acid phosphine was discovered by Paul Ehrlich and subsequently modified by Zeal and Nelson. This staining is done to identify acid phosphate organisms such as Mycobacterium tuberculosis and other acid phosphates is due to the presence of mycolic acid in the sample. Zeal Nelson's technique or hot method, the smear is prepared measuring 2 to 3 cm in size in a new green, grease-free, scratch-free slides. From the yellow purulent portion of the sputum. The smear should be neither too thick, neither too thin. When placed over printed matter, the print should be readable through the smear. Smear preparation should be done near the flame as 6 inches around flame is considered sterile zone. As heat coagulates the aerosols which are raised during the smear preparation. Heat fixation. After air drying, 15 to 30 minutes after air drying, then heat fix the smear by passing the smear over the flame 3 to 5 times for 3 to 4 seconds each time. Coagulation of proteinaceous material in the sputum will facilitate fixing of the smear. State 1, primary stain, smear is poured with strong carbon cooking 1% to 5 minutes. Intermittent heating is done by flaming to the underneath of the slide until vapor arrives. Heating helps in better penetration of the skin of the stain. Care must be taken to ensure that smear does not dry out. To counteract drying, more solution of saline should be added to the slide and the slide should be reheated. Then raise the slide with tap water until all free carbon cooking stain is washed away. At this point, the smear on the slide looks ready color. Step 2, declarization. It is done by pouring 25% sulfuric acid over the slide and allowing it to stand for 2 to 4 minutes. Slide is gently raised with tap water and tilted to drain out the water. A properly declarized slide appears light pink. If the slide is still red, sulfuric acid is reapplied for 1 to 3 minutes and then rinse gently with tap water. The back of the slide is white, clean, with swab dipped in sulfuric acid. Step 3, counter staining. 0.1% of methylene blue is poured on the slide, left for 30 seconds, and then the slide is rinsed gently with tap water. The slide is examined under binocular microscope using 4TX lens to select the suitable area and then examined under oil immersion field 100X. Contaminated materials on the slide should be discarded. Contaminated materials and the slide should be discarded in jar containing 5% phenol. Interpretation: Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Negative results, at least 100 oil immersion fields should be examined for 10 to 15 minutes before giving negative report. Positive results, Mycobacterium tuberculosis appears as a long, slender, braided, less uniformly stained red color as it was baseline. Presumptive diagnosis, microscopy provides only presumptive diagnosis if typical EDAD appearance is seen and should be reported as acids as bacilli resembling Mycobacterium tuberculosis are seen by the smear microscopy by ZS staining. Advantages of ZS staining: smear microscopy is rapid, easy to perform at peripheral laboratories, and is cheaper. Disadvantages: smear microscopy is less sensitive than culture, low sensitivity with detection limit of 10,000 bacilli per ml of sputum. Third, it cannot determine the viability of bacilli. It is difficult to differentiate Mycobacterium tuberculosis from saprophytic mycobacteria present in the tap water, even as a common cell in clinical specimens such as gastric escalate and urine. Acid alcohol, 3% hydrochloric acid plus 95% of ethyl alcohol can be used to differentiate Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Acid alcohol, fast organism. It can be differentiated from Mycobacterium smegmatis, which is only acid fast but not alcohol fast, and tuberculosis bacilli is acid as well as alcohol fast. It can be seen in urine samples. RNTCP guideline for grading the sputum. Revised National Tuberculosis Control Program, RNTCP of India, has given guidelines for grading ZS staining sputum smears that is no AFB in 100 oil immersion feed. 100 oil immersion feed to be screened. If not observed in a single organism, it should be graded 0. Result is written as negative. 1 to 9 per 100 oil immersion feed. Scanty positive can be repeated. 10 to 99 bacilli per 100 oil immersion field, 1 plus positive. 1 to 10 bacilli per oil immersion field, 2 plus positive. More than 10 bacilli per oil immersion field, field screen at least 20, 3 plus. and the slide is labeled as positive. RNDCP grading is useful for monitoring the treatment response of the patient, assessing the severity of disease, assessing the infectiousness of the patient. Higher the grade, more is the infectiousness. Smear negative patients, less than 10,000 bacilli per ml of sputum, are less infectious. However, grading of the sputum smear depends upon the quality of sputum collected. Smear cold ZS staining or acid for staining. It differs from ZS staining in that heating is not required. Second, phenol concentration of carbolfluoxin is increased, but duration of carbolfluoxin staining is more. Fluorescent staining using aramine, or also known as aramine staining. It is fluorescent staining technique use aramine phenol solution for 7 to 10 minutes as primary stain, 0.5% acid on cone for declarization for 2 minutes twice, 0.1% potassium permanganate for 30 seconds as a counter stain. Then the slide is examined under fluorescent LED light microscope. The bacilli appear brilliant yellow against the dark background. Smears are screened using 20x or 25x objective, hence it can be screened faster. 2 minutes. In 2 minutes, we can screen 100 fields. It is more sensitive than ZS staining and has been recommended for screening as a screening method by RNDCP. However, artifacts may be confounded with the interpretation, hence, the reading should be taken by an expert. Culture method. So these are the two pictures. Direct microscopic examination of sputum showing long, slender, and mediate red color acid plus bacilli in the diagram A. These are acid plus bacilli. Diagram B shows oramine phenol staining of sputum smear. The purple bacilli appear brilliant green against the dark background. So this is the anticipated reading protocol, which I have already explained. This is anticipated guidelines. Why the staining is useful for monitoring treatment response, assessing severity of the disease, assessing infectiousness of the patient. Culture is traditionally considered as a gold standard method for diagnosis of tuberculosis. It offers several advantages. It is more sensitive than microscopy, with detection unit of 10 to 100 viral bacilli, indicates viability of the bacilli. When the TB bacilli grow on culture, indicates they are viable. Drug susceptibility testing can be performed. RNDCP recommended culture media includes both conventional solid media, that is Lowenstein Jensen's medium, and the automated liquid culture such as Mycobacterium growth indicator tube major tube. Conventional solid media, Lowenstein Jensen medium, LJ media has been the most widely recommended by RNDCP. It is composed of coagulated hindsight, mineral salt solution, aspargine, and melachite as selective agent. Inoculated media are incubated for a prolonged duration, 6 to 8 weeks. This is because of the slow growing nature of tubercle bacilli. Long germination time, 10 to 15 hours. Colonies of Mycobacterium tuberculosis will be seen as typical rough, buff colored colonies. In contrast, Mycobacterium bovis produces smooth, moist, and white colored colonies that break up easily when touched. Conventional liquid media are H-less medium and the middle group 7H9 medium. They are not routinely used. Here you can see in the diagram a small, rough, tough, buff color colonies of Mycobacterium tuberculosis. The picture shows LJ medium with rough, tough, and buff color colonies of tuberculosis. Second picture is showing BACTEC magic bottle, which contains the liquid media. Automated liquid culture system monitors the growth. Continuously offer a faster turnaround time compared to conventional culture. Positive growth 99% gets detected within 3 to 4 weeks, however, negative results reported after 6 weeks of incubation. They use liquid baths such as Middlebrook 7H9 medium supplemented with enriched growth media and antibiotic mixture to inhibit other organisms. Various automated systems available, Bactec Midget, Mycobacterium growth indicator tube. This is the automated system endorsed by WHO, RNTCP. Use it detects growth of mycobacteria, also performs susceptibility testing against the first line and second line antituberculosis. It works on the principle that it uses oxygen sensitive fluorescent compound dissolved in the broth. Initially, the large amount of dissolved oxygen in the medium quenches the emission from the fluorescent compound. Later, actively respiring microorganism consumes the oxygen. The quenching effect is lost, which allows fluorescence to be detected. Other automated systems include bacteria systems. Culture identifications. The colonies grow on LJ media and the product. From positively packed automated culture bottles are first subjected to acid fasting. If found positive, then further tested for species identification. MTB64, antigen detection, rapid immunochromatographic test, which detects MTB64, 28 kilodalton antigen with a specific for tuberculosis complex containing mycobacterium tuberculosis bovis and africana and negative for NTM-31 tuberculosis mycobacterium. Automated identification systems such as multi-TOF, biochemical test, the niacin test, rapid pathogenetic test are being used. But now this is a past and are obsolete. Serological methods, both antigen and antibody detection methods are not recommended because low sensitivity, cross-reactivity with other mycobacterium are variable antibody response against different epitopes. So therefore, WHO has banned these serological tests. Molecular methods are extremely useful. They take less time than culture. They are more sensitive than culture. This is very much useful for extrapulmonary tuberculosis samples. They are usually few bacilli, having less bacilli number. They can also detect the genes coding for drug resistance, used for epidemiological typing of strains. There are several molecular methods available as described below. PCR, polymerase chain reaction, nested PCR targeting insertion sequence 6110 gene was the most common molecular test used earlier. Other genes were targeted by using PCR, MPT, 64 gene, 65 kilodalton, 38 kilodalton genes. Automated real-time PCR. With the advent of automated real-time PCR system, the diagnosis of tuberculosis has been completely revolutionized. In addition, these systems can be used for the diagnosis of other diseases such as COVID-19, and the methods are available. Cartridge-based nucleic acid amplification test, CBNAT, for example, GeneXpert. Chip-based real-time PCR, TrueNAT, for identification, detection of resistance to repurposing, having a turnaround time of 2 hours. GeneXpert, CFAS, the CBNAT system endorsed by WHO and used in India under RNTCP has lowest turnaround time of 2 hours among all the diagnostic methods currently available in TB. Its principle is it is based on RT real-time PCR technique, simultaneously detects MTB complex DNA and repurposing resistance. Mutation of RPOB gene. It uses 5 probes targeting various sequences of RPOB gene. In extrapulmonary tuberculosis, WHO recommends GeneXpert as the initial test for diagnosis, especially using CSF specimen, lymph node, and other tissue specimens. As these bacilli are more in number in pleural wall, ideal specimen for pleural tuberculosis is pleural biopsy, not pleural fluid. Its diagnostic utility. The detection limit of GeneXpert is about 131 bacilli per mm of the specimen compared to culture, the sensitivity and specificity are as follows. For detection of TB bacilli, it is 88% sensitive and 99% specific. For detection of epiphyseal resistance, it is 95% sensitive and 98% specific. Disadvantage, very expensive, cannot further speciate Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex. Next generation GeneXpert is GeneXpert Ultra. It is also endorsed by WHO in 2017. Contains two additional molecular targets to detect TB. Insertion sequence 6110, 6 insertion sequence 1081. It is more sensitive and specific than GeneXpert with the detection limit of 16 bacilli per hour. CPI-based TrueNAT is the cheapest real-time PCR system validated recently by ICMR in 2007, also endorsed by WHO in 2019 and used in India under RT-CP. It has been developed by the Indian firm Bond Biodiagnostics. Advantages: it is an automated battery-operated device, can be used at the level of primary health center, where GeneXpert cannot be used as it needs uninterrupted power supply and air condition. The true turnaround time is around 1 hour. Disadvantage, very expensive, cannot further speciate Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex. It tests only limited samples, 1 to 4 at dawn time. Lyme probe assay, it involves probe test detection, amplifies DNA in the specimen, uses LPA in TB diagnostic as following uses: identification of MTB complex, detection of resistance to first-line anti-tubercular drugs, speciation of Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex and MTM, detection of resistance to second-line anti-tubercular drugs. Limitations: LPA can be performed only on positive cultures or smears, positive clinical specimen. It is not recommended for smear negative specimen as the sensitivity is low. Lyme probe assay is useful particularly in isoniazide monoresistance cases of tuberculosis which are not diagnosed by GeneXpert. Diagnosis of latent tuberculosis. Latent tuberculosis is diagnosed by demonstration of delayed type of hypersensitivity reaction, type 2 hypersensitivity reaction on tuberculosis bacilli antigen. Two methods are the tuberculin test and interferon gamma release assay, IGRA. Traditional tuberculin skin test has been used for now the diagnosis of latent tuberculosis. Can use a WHO recommended preparation of purified protein derivatives known as PPD23 for performing tuberculin skin test. Doses exposed to tuberculin units, TU. 1 TU is equal to 0.00002 microgram of purified protein derivative. Mentox test procedure. Mentox test is the most widely employed method. 0.1 ml of PPD containing 1 TU is injected intradermally into flexure surface of forearm. Reading: it is taken after 48 to 72 hours at the site of inoculation and induration surrounded by erythema, which is produced. If width of induration is more than or equal to 10 mm, the test is positive, tuberculin reactors. 6 to 9 equivocal, doubtful reaction, less than 5 mm, negative. Interpretation of results: positive tuberculin skin test in adult only indicates present or past exposure to the tuberculin bacilli but does not confirm the presence of active stage of the disease. Hence, it is only used as an epidemiological marker. Prevalence of tuberculosis is calculated by counting all tuberculin reactors in the community. Incidence of tuberculosis is calculated by counting new communicators to skin test from the candidate. In children, a positive test indicates actual infection and used as a diagnostic mark. False positive. The test becomes positive after BCG vaccination, after 18 to 14 weeks, non-tuberculous mycobacterial infection. False negative, the test may become negative in various conditions such as early or advanced tuberculosis, major tuberculosis, and decreased immunity due to HIV infection in HIV-infected individuals. IGRA, interferon gamma release, this is highly specific mycobacterial tuberculosis antigen such as CIF10, CFP10, culture-filtered protein, or early secreted antigen target ES86. Both coded by RD1 gene procedure. In contrast to tuberculin skin test, it is an in vitro test. Sensitized lymphocytes collected from suspected individual are exposed to ESAT6 or CFP10 antigens, which lead to release of high level of interferon gamma from the T lymphocytes. An ELISA format is available commercially. QuantiFERON TB gold assay advantage, it is highly specific. There are no false positive results. This is the diagnostic algorithm for pulmonary tuberculosis. Pulmonary presumptive TB patient, smear examination, chest X-ray, smear positive, regardless of chest X-ray report. Smear negative but chest X-ray suggests TB. Smear and chest X-ray either negative or not available with high clinical suspicion. All these should be directed to CBNET. If people living with HIV/AIDS or pediatric PPTB or presumptive drug-resistant tuberculosis, their samples should be directly subjected to CBNET. In CBNET, if MTB detected, then look for if it is insensitive, resistance, or intermediate. If it is sensitive, microbiologically confirmed TB. If it is intermediate, repeat CBNET on the second sample. If it is resistance, refer to management for referring patient resistance. If intermediate, on second sample, collect the fresh sample for liquid culture or line progress. If MTB not detected or CBNET result not available, if clinical suspicion is high, consider alternate diagnosis or report clinically diagnosed tuberculosis. Drug susceptibility testing. Several methods of drug susceptibility testing are available, which can be grouped into phenotypic method, MAGIT, used for first and second line drugs. Resistance is determined by growth of tubercle bacilli in drug containing tube as compared to the control tube, which is drug free within 4 to 21 days of inoculation. Proportion method, used for first and second line drugs. Also, an isolate is considered resistant to given drug when the growth of 1% or more is observed in the drug containing LG medium compared to the control LG medium without drug after 48 days of inoculation. Genotypic methods, gene expert detects resistant to rifampicin by targeting 5 different sequences of RPO gene. Turnaround time is less than 2 hours. Line progressing detect resistant to both first line and second line drugs. Turnaround time is 2 to 3 days. UDST, universal drug susceptibility testing, refers to testing all tuberculosis patients for resistance to at least rifampicin by performing CBNET. UDST program has been rolled out across India since January 2018. Treatment of tuberculosis, anti-tubercular drugs, ETDs are enlisted as below. First line drugs used for the treatment of drug susceptible tuberculosis, DSTB. Second line drug used for the treatment of resistant tuberculosis, DRT. This is the chart showing antituberculous drugs for treatment of drug tuberculosis, drug susceptible tuberculosis and drug resistant tuberculosis. First line agents, isoniazid, rifampicin, pyrazinamide, ethambutol. Group A fluoroquinolones, which comes under second line agents for drug resistant tuberculosis. Eofloxacin, moxifloxacin, gatifloxacin. Group B second line injectable agents are amikacin, capreomycin, kanamycin, streptomycin. Group C other second line agents include ethionamide, prothionamide, cycloserine, linzolid. Group D add-on agents, not part of the core multi-drug resistant tuberculosis region. Group 1 first line agent, pyrazinamide, ethambutol, iDose, isoniazid. Group 2 new agents, bedaquiline, delmide. Group 3 agents, amipenem, clostridium, eropenem, amoxicillin, triazolam, thioacetazole, para-aminosalicylic acid. Treatment of tuberculosis aims to interrupt transmission by rendering patient non-infectious, prevent morbidity and death by curing patient, prevent emergence of drug resistance and prevent relapse. Multi-drug therapy is a combination of more than one drug. Short course chemotherapy lasting for 6 months or longer for drug resistant tuberculosis. Two-phase chemotherapy is a short course divided into intensive phase and continuation phase. Intensive phase where multiple antituberculous drugs that are rapidly kill bacilli, making the smear negative, followed by continuation phase aims at killing the remaining dormant bacilli and prevent relapse. Directly observed treatment short course dots strategy recommended by RNTCP and WHO. Here strategies are used. The entire treatment course is supervised to improve patient's compliance, treatment response, monitored by sputum smear microscopy at the end of each phase. Sensitivity testing, if found as rifampicin sensitive, then line probe assay is performed for other first line antituberculous drugs, for example for isoniazid. If found as rifampicin resistant, then line probe assay is performed for second line agents such as fluoroquinolones and second line injectable drugs. Treatment region based on drug susceptibility, all cases of tuberculosis should be subjected to CVNAC. Rifampicin resistance observed, then should be subjected to second line LP, which will give you fluoroquinolone and second line injectable sensitivity. If observed, initiate MDR regimen. If fluoroquinolone resistant, second line injectable sensitive, initiate pre-XDR tuberculosis regimen. If fluoroquinolone sensitive, second line injectable resistant, initiate pre-XDR tuberculosis regimen. If fluoroquinolone resistant, second line injectable resistant, initiate XDR tuberculosis regimen. If rifampicin sensitive after CVNAC, subject to first line probe assay. Isoniazid sensitive, look for isoniazid sensitivity and resistance. If sensitive, initiate drug sensitive tuberculosis regimen. If resistant, initiate H monopoly regime. Standard regime for drug sensitive tuberculosis, it's a 6 month course, two phases, intensive phase. First phase is intensive phase. Four drugs, which includes HRZD, 2 months. Followed by continuation phase with the three drugs, HRE for 4 months. Second, FDC, all drugs fixed dose combination tablets as per appropriate weight requirements. And daily oral reaching includes fixed dose combination tablets taken orally once a day. Regimens for drug-resistant tuberculosis uses higher numbers of second-line agents given for longer duration. So drug-sensitivity tuberculosis, regimen name, no resistance, intensive phase 1, HREZ, that is which are these drugs? HREZ. Which are these drugs? These drugs are isoniazid, rifampicin, pyrazinamide, and ethambutol. Continuation phase includes only isoniazid, rifampicin, and ethambutol. H-mono or polytherapy regime, that is for drug-resistant tuberculosis, that includes levofloxacin, moxifloxacin, and rifampicin, ethambutol, and pyrazinamide. It is continued in second, and continuation phase includes levofloxacin, rifampicin, ethambutol, and pyrazinamide. Multidrug resistant tuberculosis or rifampicin resistant tuberculosis, ARA. Shorter MDR tuberculosis regime is given in first phase, 4 to 6 months, moxifloxacin is given. Then canamycin is given, second line injectable agent. Then ethionamide is given, which is second line agent, other second line agent. Then cycloserine, then pyrazinamide, and ethambutol is given. In continuation, it include moxifloxacin, fluoxazamine, CFZ, then pyrazinamide, and ethambutol. Conventional multi-drug resistant tuberculosis regime 5, that includes levofloxacin, canamycin, then ethionamide, cycloserine, pyrazinamide, and ethambutol. In continuation phase, levofloxacin, ethionamide, cycloserine, and ethambutol. PHDR regime for multidrug resistant or rifampicin resistant or rifampicin and chloroplast includes canamycin, ethambutol, cycloserine, pyrazinamide, linezolid, chlorpromazine, and radofluid. In continuation phase, ethionamide, cycloserine, linezolid, and chlorpromazine. XDR-TB regime for multidrug resistant tuberculosis, rifampicin resistance tuberculosis plus rifampicin and chloroplasmin and second line injectable. It includes moxifloxacin, then capremycin, ethionamide, cycloserine, linezolid, chlorpromazine, pyrazinamide, and ethambutol. In continuation, moxifloxacin, ethionamide, cycloserine, linezolid, chlorpromazine, and ethambutol is given. So yeah, as per the weight category, the tablets are given in 25 to 30 kilogram, 2 tablets in intensive phase, and in continuation phase also 2 tablets. In case of 40 to 54 category weight, 3 tablets for both initial and continuation. If the weight is 55 to 69 kilogram, 4 tablets in both the phases. More than 70, 5 tablets in both the phases. Follow-up treatment, clinical follow-up carried out at least monthly during treatment. Follow-up laboratory investigation for P PTP, sputum smear, done at the end of intensive phase. At the end of treatment, sputum smear plus culture done for every patient. Long-term follow-up is carried out for up to 2 years for completion of treatment. Follow-up of MDR tuberculosis sputum smears and culture performed every month during intensive phase and every 3 months during continuation. New antimicrobial drugs, Bataquilin and Telamanid, only two drugs developed specifically for the treatment of tuberculosis in the last 40 years. Bataquilin is a new second-line antitubercular drug for eribulin class, approved for use of second-line antituberculosis since 2015, acts by inhibiting mycobacterial ATP synthesis, strongly mycobactericidal, and cross-resistance with other ETDs, significant benefit in improving the time to culture conversion in MDR patient. Recommended for MDR tuberculosis or FDR tuberculosis cases, resistant to fluoroquinolone and other second-line injectable drugs. Contraindicated in pregnancies and age below 18 years, Bataquilin-containing regimen should be contained four other second-line antitubercular drugs depending upon the sensitivity. Delamanid, derived from nitroimidazole class, mechanism of action by inhibiting mycolic acid synthesis of bacterial cell wall, approved for use in treatment of drug-resistant tuberculosis, MDR-XDR, or mixed pattern drug-resistant tuberculosis in combination regimen. Exclusion criteria, children under 6 years, pregnant and breastfeeding females, patient with prolonged QT interval and if hypersensitivity develops. Resistance to antitubercular drug, primary or preterm drug resistance, infection of an individual by drug resistance strain, not previously been treated and less common. Acquired resistance, which is secondary or post-treatment, initially sensitive, becomes resistant later due to inappropriate and inadequate treatment, and it is more common. Mechanism of drug resistance due to point mutation in the genome of Mycobacterium tuberculosis, which occurs at the rate of 1 in 10 raised to 8 cells division. You can see the table. The resistance genes present in M. tuberculosis, isoniazide, phenol ACP, reductase, INHA, catalase peroxidase, CATG, alkali, hydroperoxide reduces, AHPC, rifampicin, NA polymerase subunit, RPOP, pyrazinamidase, and PNCA, ethambutol, ribosomal protein subunit, RPSL, streptomycin, ribosomal protein subunit 12, RPSL, 16S ribosomal RRS, aminoglycoside, phosphate transferase gene, STRA, and phosphoroquinolone gene kinase, that is GRYAMP. So failure to adapt to the multi-drug resistant gene region due to prolonged duration of treatment, poor compliance of the patient, develop toxicity to the drugs, improper supervision, and follow-up. Mono-resistance is to the first line antitubercular drug only, polyresistant to more than one first-line antitubercular drug, other than both isoniazid and rifampicin resistance, with or without resistant to antitubercular drug, includes any resistant to rifampicin in the form of monoresistance, polyresistance, MDR or XDR. Resistant to isoniazid and rifampicin with or without resistant to other first-line drug. In 2018, 3.4% of new and 18% of previously treated cases are MDR and rifampicin resistant TB. In 2018, MDR TB rate in India was 6.19% in all tuberculosis patients. Intensive phase of 4 to 9 months with 6 to 7 second line agents, followed by continuation phase of 5 to 18 months with 4 second line agents, is the treatment of MDR tuberculosis. DOTS Plus program, initiated by RNTCP in 2000, covered the diagnosis and treatment of MDR cases. XDR, extensively resistant tuberculosis, MDR cases which are also resistant to chloroquinolone, rifloxacin, moxifloxacin, catiploxacin, and at least one second line injectable agent, amikacin, capreomycin, kanamycin, are termed as extensively resistant tuberculosis strains. Pre-XDR TB refers to the resistance to either fluconazole, second line injectable agents, but not both. In India, among MDR TB cases, 21% were resistant to chloroquinolones and 3.6% resistant to second line injectable agents. Global and national treatment programs, the NTB strategy run by WHO, revised national tuberculosis control program by the Government of India, national strategy plan, India 2020 to 2025, Nixon, and 99 talks. Nixon, it is a web portal introduced since 2018 for surveillance of TB. The Government of India has made a mandate for all healthcare providers to notify all TB cases through this website. 99 dots, it is named so, as a very high success rate of about 99% is expected by the remote inbuilt techno supervision. It is low-cost mobile phone-based technology available since 2016 that enables real-time remote monitoring of daily intake of treatment in tuberculosis HIV co-infected individuals. BCG vaccination. BCG strain used in India is WHO recommended Danish 1331 strain, prepared in Central BCG Laboratory, Unity, Chennai. It is reconstituted, available in lyophilized form, reconstituted before administration, administered using normal saline as a diluent. Distilled water is never used as it irritates. Reconstituted, it has to be administered within 1 hour, 0.1 ml, 0.1 microgram. TU of BCG vaccine is administered above the insertion of left deltoid by intradermal route using 26-valve tubule syringe. The BCG is properly injected intradermally, then followed phenomenal develop. Following phenomenal develop, after 2 to 3 weeks, rapid develops, 5 to 6 weeks, shallow ulcer develops, which is covered with crust, 6 to 12 weeks. Permanent tiny round scar, 4 to 8 mm, diameter is formed, 8 to 14 weeks, amount of stress becomes positive. If overdose is given, then regional scar becomes larger and irregular size. It protection. Efficacy is variable from 0 to 80%. Duration of immunity lasts for 15 to 20 years. Though BCG may not protect from risk of tuberculosis infection, it surely gives protection to infant and young children against development of complications such as tuberculosis meningitis, and disseminated tuberculosis. Complications following BCG. Most common complication include ulceration at the site of vaccination and regional lymphadenitis, rarely keloid or lupus lesions, and osteomyelitis may develop, rarely non-fatal meningitis, progressive tuberculosis, and disseminated BCG infection, that is called as BCGitis, is reported in people with low immunity. Direct BCG is given to newborns soon after birth. This strategy is followed by most of the developing countries, including India. If not given at birth, it can be given at a maximum of 2 years. Indirect BCG is given after performing tuberculin test. Contraindication to BCG includes HIV positive child born to Staphylococcus bacilli positive smear, mother, child with low immunity, generalized eczema, and pregnancy. Chemoprophylaxis treatment selected high risk tuberculin reactors, that is people with latent tuberculosis, aims to preventing active disease. Isoniazid or ethambutol for 6 months. Stride can prophylaxis has several shortcomings, such as expensive risk of developing tuberculosis in immunotuberculin reactors and side effects of both the drugs. Ionis preventive therapy, restricted to limited indication, adults with HIV, children with HIV, and all children with HIV. Non-tuberculous mycobacterial infections. Non-tuberculous mycobacteria is a diverse group of mycobacteria isolated from bird, animals, and environmental source. Opportunistic pathogen, occasionally associated with human infection. Man-to-man transmission is not known. Saprophytic mycobacteria, which are isolated from soil, water, and other environmental sources. They do not cause any disease in humans. So there are Linnaeus classification of non-tuberculous mycobacteria, which includes photochrome, scotochrome, non-photochrome, and rapid growths. Photochromes, they have the property to produce pigments only in light. Scotochrome produces pigments both in dark and light. Non-photochromogens do not produce any kind of pigment in exposure to light or even in dark. Rapid growths grow within 1 week. Comparatively rapid growing ability than other mycobacteria. Photochrome includes marinal, ascitical, semi, tensasi, genuins. Scotochromogens, Zolgi, Gordoni. Non-photochromogens, AVM intracellulary complex, Xenopi, paratuberculosis, rapid growths, Chiloni, Potitum, Smigmatis. Photochromogens, Mycobacterium, Marinum, causes swimming pool granuloma, which is with the papules and ulcers, LLEC. After swimming in water sources such as fish tank, ingest through minor trauma. Mycobacterium aceticum, rarely associated with pulmonary disease and prostatitis. CV, isolated from pulmonary region, tensasi causes chronic pulmonary disease and tuberculosis. Genuins causes infection in patient with advanced HIV. Scrofulasa causes scrofula. Cervical lymphadenitis in children, cordoni, common saline drop water, common contaminant in clinical specimen, rarely isolated from pulmonary specimen, Zolgi, scotochromogen at 37 degrees Celsius and photochromogen at 25 degrees Celsius, occasionally causes pulmonary disease and prostatitis. M. cilatum, rare cause of pulmonary infection. Non-photochromogens, ABM intracellulary complex, Patty bacillus, isolated from birds, Mycobacterium intracellulari. Opportunistic pathogen in HIV, infected, low CD4 T cell count, patient, usually less than 50 microgram per liter, lymphadenitis, respiratory infection, and disseminated disease. Xenopi, hospital water supplies, and associated with nosocomial outbreaks. Rarely causes pulmonary disease in HIV-infected individuals. M. ulcerans causes pearly ulcer, painless ulcer, and nodules, necrosis, seen laterals, can lead to osteomyelitis, limb deformities. Mycobacterium potitum and Mycobacterium chiloni causes post-trauma infection, abscess, catheter infection. Pulmonary infections by AVM intracellulary complex, Zolgi, lymph node infection, AVM intracellulary complex, scrofulasa, cutaneous infection, marinum ulcerans, abscesses, AVM intracellular complex, disseminated infection, AVM intracellular complex, and pulses. Laboratory diagnosis of NTM, specimens, sputum, lymph node, aspirate plus exudate biopsy from skin lesions are usual specimen depending on the type of infection. Microscopy by ZN staining shows red acid plus bacillus. Culture on LJ media, several species of NTM grow well on LJ. Pigment production, LJ media incubated in dark and light separately for distinguishing photochromogens and scotochromogens. Identification, negative for MPT64 antigen by ICT, differentiating from mycobacterial tuberculosis, newer methods such as MRD-TOF and PCR. Treatment of NTM, EVM intracellular complex, tensasi and marinum infections are treated with multi-drug therapy with metformin, clarithromycin or azithromycin, ethambutol and rifampin. NTM resistant to most of the first line and second line antibacterial. Mycobacterium definitely. Disease recognized since Vedic times in India and Bible times in Middle East. Affected person is considered as unclean and socially outcasted. Today term leper, because of its social stigma, is not socially acceptable and the disease is known as Hansen's disease. So, bacilli was first observed by Hansen's in 1864, hence the name is given after Hansen's discovery. Though it is amongst the first bacterial pathogen of humans to be described, but remains one of the least understood. This is because of its inability to grow in artificial culture. Morphologically, it is a straight or curved rod, 1 to 10, 2.2 to 0.5 micrometer. Acid-fast bacilli, there is decolorization up to 5% hysteresis. It can be observed as cigar-like bundles of bacilli present inside lipid-laden macrophages called Virchow's lepra cells. Cultivation, it cannot be cultivated in multicultural media, can be cultivated in animals such as nine-banded armadillo, nine Indian pangolin, chimpanzees, etc. Shepard in 1960 cultivated it into food pad of mice at low temperature, above 20 degrees Celsius. Following intradermal inoculation in food pad of mice, a granuloma developed at the site of inoculation within 1 to 6 months. Its generation time is 12 to 13 days. The picture shows Virchow cells with the mycobacterium laden in the typical cigar or weedy bundle shape. You can see. This is 9-banded armadillo. This can be kept in examination picture. We have a specimen of it. Hansen's disease, leprosy, is a chronic granulomatous disease of humans, primarily involving skin, peripheral nerves, and nasal mucosa, but capable of affecting any tissue or organ. Disease is classified into four types by Myrid in 1953, Lepromatous Tuberculoid Dimorphous Interim. Depends on the degree of immunity of the individual, hence the forms may vary with chemotherapy and alteration in the procedure. Lepromatous and tuberculoid forms are the two extreme forms of the disease. Lepromatous leprosy shows no resistance of patient. Lepromata, that is superficial nodular lesion, develops. They can be many in number, nodule ulcerate and become secondarily infected, causing distortion and mutilation. Bacilli invert mucosa of mouth, nose, upper respiratory. Bacilli shed in large number in oral and nasal secretions, called as multivascular disease. Nerve lesions are variant. Lepromatous leprosy, reticuloendothelial system, eyes, testes, kidneys, and bones are also involved. The most infective form than others, cell-mediated immunity is deficient. Results in lepromin test is negative, lymphocyte transformation test is negative. Humoral immune response is exaggerated. Antibodies against mycobacteria as well as other antigens are produced. In most cases, it shows biological false positivity with standard test for syphilis due to common autoantibodies. Prognosis is poor. Tuberculoid leprosy, host resistance is high, skin lesions are very few, sharply demarcated, consisting macular anesthetic patches. Neural involvement may be early and strongly marked, causing deformities. Mainly observed on hands, feet, bacilli scanty in these lesions. Infectivity is very low, cell mediated immunity is adequate, autoantibodies are very rare. Autoantibodies or antibodies are very rare. Lepromin test is positive, called as poor bacillary disease, few bacillary disease, prognosis is good. Dimorphous or borderline, third one, characteristic of both tuberculosis and lepromatous, depends on host immunity and chemotherapy, lepromin test is variable. Fourth one, intermediate, do not resemble either tuberculosis or lepromatous, lepromin test is variable. Indian classification has additional type, pure neuritic type. Bacteriologically negative, show neural involvement without any skin lesion. The table shows difference between lepromatous and tuberculoid leprosy. Characters: bacillary load, multivacillary, lepromatous leprosy, eubacillary, tuberculoid leprosy. Bacteriological index 4 to 6 plus, 0 to 1 plus. Skin lesion, mean is symmetrical, margin is irregular, lesions appear as multinodules, lepromata, plaque and exanthema like. While in tuberculoid leprosy, one or few, symmetrical, margin is sharp, lesions appear hyperpigmented, hypopigmented, annular macules with elevated borders. Nerve lesions are late in lepromatous leprosy, early involvement seen in tuberculosis. Sedimentary immunity is low in lepromatous leprosy, it is normal in tuberculosis. Lepromatosis is negative in lepromatous leprosy and it is positive in tuberculosis. Ridley and Joplin's classification, 1966, introduces a scale of classifying spectrum of leprosy into 5 groups that classifies tuberculoid, borderline tuberculoid, borderline lepromatous, and lepromatous. Ridley and Joplin classification, Madras classification, and Indian classification, both with three of them we'll see in this table: lepromatous leprosy type in Madrid, and Indian classification, lepromatous type. Borderline lepromatous leprosy, BL, that is called as borderline in Madrid, borderline in India. Borderline leprosy in RG, intermediate type in Madrid, intermediate type in Indian classification. Borderline tuberculoid leprosy, GT, in Argent, Madrid, it is called as tuberculoid type. In Indian, it is called as tuberculoid. Argent, Joplin classification, tuberculoid leprosy, TT. Madrid does not classify this fifth type. In India, Indian classification, it is tuberculoid. Epidemiology, it's exclusively a human disease. Source of infection is always a patient, which can discharge. 18 to 10 to 8 bacilli in one nose blow. Mode of infection, exact mode of infection is unclear, but maybe excretion of bacilli through nose or other excretions by infected individuals. Mode of entry through respiratory tract or skin. Asymptomatic infections are common in endemic area and not highly communicable. Develops only in 5% spouse living with leprosy patient. Incubation period is very long, to 5 years, may take up to 30 years. India has maximum prevalence with about 1/3 of the global total cases. Present throughout India. Ulcers, lysis of bone worsened from careless use of hands. No damage. Lepromatous versus tuberculosis. Early and death stage of lepromatous leprosy. A high degree of innate immunity against lepra bacilli seems to exist in humans, so only minority of infected may lead to disease. Infection lead to both cell mediated immunity and humoral immunity. Humoral antibodies do not have hereditary secret. One lepra bacilli, but cell-mediated immunity can destroy the bacilli. Type of leprosy decides status of cell-mediated immunity in particular patient. Adequate in case of tuberculosis. Delayed type of hypersensitivity is exhibited to lepra bacillus protein. The macrophages phagocytize the bacilli and destroy them. Humoral antibodies are not common. Deficient in case of lepromatosis. Delayed type of hypersensitivity to lepra bacillus protein is absent. Macrophages are able to phagocytize bacilli, but they proliferate inside macrophages. Allergic nature of leprosy. Although chronic disease, till of allergic nature, according to that, divide into two types. Reversal reaction or lepra reaction. Mostly seen in borderline leprosy, occurring spontaneously or more often during chemotherapy. It is a cell-mediated immunity with an influx of lymphocytes into lesion and a shift to tuberculoid morphology. The lesion developed erythema, swelling along with pain and tenderness. A similar clinical picture can be seen in downgrading reaction, which usually occurs in untreated and pregnant patients. Biopsy shows shift to lepromatous pattern, reflecting decrease of cell-mediated immunity. Erythema nodosum leprosum, ENL, an inflammatory complication of leprosy that results in painful skin lesion on arms and legs and face. Of course, in leptomatous leprosy and borderline leprosy types, few months after institution of chemotherapy, this is an orthosis reaction to antigen release from dead lepra cells and characterized by neutrophils, infiltration, IgG, and complement deposition in the lesions. Lepromin test, a test utilizing intradermal injection of lepromin, such as Dharmendra antigen or Mitsuda antigen, to classify the stage of leprosy based on lepromin reaction, such as Fernandez reaction and Mitsuda reaction. Fernandez reaction, the early response shows edema and duration developing in 24 to 48 hours and remains for 3 to 5 days. Analogous to tuberculin reaction, poorly defined with details in movements. Mitsuda reaction is the second and more meaningful reaction, starting under 2 weeks, reaching to peak 4 weeks. Reaction consists of indurated skin rolling, which may observe, gradually subsides in next few weeks. It does not indicate pre-existing delayed type of hypersensitivity to major cell-mediated immunity induced due to injection of lepromin. This distinguishes between the person who can mount a cell-mediated immunity response against leprobacillus antigen and those who cannot. Lepromin test, it differentiates tuberculoid leprosy in which there is a positive delayed type of hypersensitivity reaction at the injection site. Lepromatous leprosy, which there is no reaction, that is negative test result despite active malignant mycobacterium leprae infection. The test is not diagnostic since normal uninfected person may react. Lepromin test employed for to classify lesions of leprosy. Positive tuberculoid, negative lepromatous, variable dimorphos intermediate to assess prognosis and response to treatment, positive good prognosis, negative bad prognosis to assess resistance to individual leprosy, desirable to recruit lepromin positive to work for leprosy patient, as lepromin negative person may be more prone to develop disease. Lab diagnosis of leprosy, easy in lepromatous, difficult in tuberculoid. Demonstration of AP, nasal mucosa, skin lesion, or ear lobes, skin clippings from 5 to 6 areas, buttocks, forehead, chin, cheek, and ear. Lab diagnosis lies mainly in microscopy, 9-banded armadillo, mouse foot pad inoculation. FLA ABS, fluorescent leprosy antibody absorption test, also identifies subclinical cases, detects sub-specific antibodies, irrespective of duration and stage. 92 to 100% sensitive. Antibody detection for Mycobacterium leprae glycolipid antigen found in 95% of untreated lepromatous leprosy patients. Titer decreases with effective therapy. Low sensitivity about 60%. So microscopy shows 0.5% of acid alcohol or 0.5% sulfuric acid is used. Mycobacterium leprae, as they are much less acid and alcohol cost than Mycobacterium tuberculobacillus. Concentration of H2SO4 used for other acid for structures, 1% H2SO4 for actinomycetes in tissue, 0.5% for nocardia, 0.25% to 0.5% for spores and oocysts of Cryptosporidium and Isospora. Grading bacteriological and morphological index, 1 plus 1 to 10 per 100 oil immersion field, 2 plus 1 to 10 per 10 field of oil immersion, 3 plus 1 to 10 per oil immersion field, 4 plus 10 to 100 per oil immersion field, 5 plus 100 to 1000 per oil immersion field, 6 plus more than 1000 per oil immersion field, or globally in every field. Prophylaxis, early case detection and prompt treatment and chemoprophylaxis. Three-bacillary disease is treated with Dapsone and rifampicin. Multibacillary disease is treated with Dapsone, rifampicin and clofazimine. This picture shows lepromatous leprosy pre and post treatment. So, questions, MCQs, positive tuberculin test is indicated by an area of induration more than or equal to 10 mm in diameter is the answer. Servile open tuberculosis inside macrophages is due to inhibition of entry into the host cell, inhibition of entry into the parasols, inhibition of fibrolysosome fusion, or inhibition degradation of lysosome. in the region of rival isosome. Fusion is the answer. Thank you so much. Hope you all have enjoyed and learned. If you have any questions, doubt, please contact me. WhatsApp group. Kindly post your response with your roll number. This practical is for batch A on Wednesday, 31st March, and batch B, 1st April 2020.